Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going to talk about the NIVEA Care Cream. Now, NIVEA says that this cream gives you intensive nourishment without a greasy feeling. They also say it contains light hydrolyzes, which melt directly onto the skin. And they say that it feels light on the skin while providing more than 24 hours of intensive nourishment. So, of course, we're going to check that out today, but first, let's break down the ingredients. Unlike the original NIVEA, the formulation of the NIVEA Care Cream is not based on very thick occlusives. But it does have a bunch of emollient ingredients that soften the skin by slowing down the evaporation of water. Now let's mention just a few. First one in the line is the shea butter. This is a skin conditioning agent and it also acts as a viscosity controlling agent. And this one is an amazing moisturizer and emollient. It soothes the skin and it also has a bunch of antioxidants, so it also helps with protecting your skin from the external factors. Next in line is the glycerin. Glycerin is the moisturizing humectant, and I already talked about humectants. Humectants increase the water content of the top layer of the skin. And the last three emollient ingredients that I would like to talk about here are the ones that are actually comedogenic. Now, compared to the original NIVEA cream, this is not too bad. Original NIVEA cream actually has a lot more comedogenic ingredients. So if you're not acne prone, you really don't have nothing to worry about here. Now let's talk about the sensory characteristics of this cream, and to say the least, this one is a lot lighter and a lot easier to spread around in comparison to the original NIVEA cream, and I'm going to show you that on my face. As you can see, it's really easy to spread around and it gives you amazing moisture right away without that greasy overlay on the face. Here's how my face is looking right after applying it. It really gives a sort of a radiant effect. It really gives you moisture and radiance at the same time. And I waited half an hour before applying makeup. I feel like that was just enough. And here I'm going to show you how foundation looks on top of this. Okay, so here is a close-up of my skin right after I applied foundation. I don't know, for me this looks amazing. It is radiant, glowy, and very natural looking. My skin looks like skin. Now I did set this with just a little bit of powder and I was good to go. And so here I went ahead and I finished my makeup, and stay tuned because after this I will be giving you my final opinion regarding the NIVEA Care Cream. In case you're new to this channel, let me just introduce myself really quickly. My name is Dani and I am a pharmacist specialized in cosmetology, and that's why I make these fun informative videos in which I analyze ingredients and give you full reviews of cosmetic and makeup products. So if this is interesting to you, if this is your type of content, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on my future uploads. Thank you so much. Now let's talk about the NIVEA cream. Now, I have a lot of good things to say about this cream because, spoiler alert, I love it. So first of all, it's a great moisturizer. I have dry skin and this moisturizes my face really, really well. I can use it as a day cream and as a night cream. Even when I apply it in the evening as a night cream, when I wake up in the morning, my skin still feels moisturized. That's great because usually when I'm applying a regular moisturizer as a night cream, if it's not intended to be a night cream, usually when I get up in the morning, my skin feels dry again. With this one, that's not the case, so you can definitely use this one as a day cream and as a night cream, so that's great. One more pro, one more good thing about this cream is that I actually think I only have pros for this cream. Maybe one con, you will see that later. So another amazing thing about this NIVEA cream is that it does not have as many comedogenic ingredients as the original NIVEA that I already did a review on. You can check it out right here. Original NIVEA does have a couple of comedogenic ingredients, like 5 or 6, something like that. This one only has 1 or 2. I will list them right here. And if you're dry or normal, if you have dry or normal skin, you don't really have to worry about comedogenic things. Or if a cream has 1 or 2 comedogenic ingredients, you don't really have to worry about that. But if you are acne prone, then maybe search for a moisturizer that has like a huge stamp on it, non-comedogenic or something like that, if you're really prone to that. I actually have a friend who is oily, who has oily skin, and she actually recommended this cream for me, so she didn't have any problems with her skin and she uses this one and she's oily. That's a really good news for people who are oily and looking for also a good moisturizer. So overall, it's a great moisturizer, great as a day cream, great as a night cream, great underneath makeup, probably not going to clog your pores because of the ingredients. So those are all pros. You can see why I'm loving this cream, and if I really would have to
pick something out as a con. The only thing would be that it's not a sunscreen and it doesn't have any UV filters. All that I'm trying to say is that you should rely on this cream to be your main daily moisturizer, because you should always have moisturizer with broad spectrum UVA and UVB protection and at least SPF 30. That's what I'm saying. So this is a really good moisturizer, but I wouldn't rely solely on this moisturizer as my daily moisturizer, because I need that sun protection in my skincare. And so do you, trust me. You can use this one as a night cream, and if you're staying in the house all day, this can be a great moisturizer. But if you're going outside, just wear sunscreen, please. Okay, so there you have it. That will be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it and if you found it helpful, please hit the like button, because liking this video actually triggers the almighty algorithm, and then YouTube shows my videos to more people. You know how it goes. So it would really mean the world to me if you could support me like that, only if you really enjoyed this video and if you found it helpful. And of course, leave a comment down below. What would you like me to review next? I actually read all the comments and I put all your requests in my content calendar, so... Anyways, thanks again for watching. Check out more videos here, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! I'm becoming really weird in front of the camera. Like, what's going on? When did I become this person? Like, when did this happen? I have dry skin, and usually nothing breaks me out. I mean, thank God for now.